Hello, everyone, and welcome. I'm Jaren Nelson, and I'm a licensed spiritual practitioner here at the Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota. We are delighted that you are spending some time with us today. Our coming together in this fashion reminds us that spiritual community does not require a building. It simply requires love, caring, and a sense of the one infinite presence that connects and holds us all. And so, recognizing that one presence in all, I now greet you with the Sanskrit word, namaste, which means the divinity in me acknowledges and honors the divinity in you. If you're wondering what our center is about, it can be summed up in the words from our website that you now see on your screen. Each Sunday, we as a spiritual community declare that we are a spiritual center that honors all paths to God. Ours is a positive message, inspiring our possibilities and offering spiritual tools for transforming our lives and helping to make the world a better place. Here, we can find peace of mind, belonging to a spiritual home, and a personal relationship with the God of our understanding. We are here to discover what we already know. And now, I invite you to join me as we go within for a few moments and reacquaint ourselves with that inner stillness that is always there. As the outside world fades away, let the words of the chant, "God is holding me" by Donna Michael, wash over you, and allow yourself to be comforted and uplifted by its truth.
I'm held in love, I'm held in peace. God is holding me. With every breath, with every step, God is holding me. 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 I'm God is holding me. God is holding me. God is holding me. God is holding me. God.
We are grateful and thankful to know that the unfailing arms of God are holding us right now. It is such a comfort to know that no matter what is facing us, we're held and upheld in infinite love and unending peace that transcends all circumstances. love and peace now drowned our anxieties and concerns. Love and peace perfectly guide our thoughts to higher ground and our sights to brighter vistas. For love and peace is what we all are. And so we now surrender any thought or belief that opposes the truth of the love and peace that resides in us and also is what we are. We persistently and wholeheartedly embrace all manner of good in our lives, knowing we are worthy. We're done living in lack and limitation and playing small. We're done with thoughts of separation that would have us believing that the gift has been given to some, but not to all. For we declare God's gifts of love and peace, in fact, all God's good, has been bestowed to all and to all alike. We gratefully and readily accept this for ourselves and for all of God's creation. For as we accept the gifts given, we share the benefits with others, for we are all one. We surrender to our greatest, highest good. We know that it is done. We let it be so, and so it is. Our spiritual leader, the Reverend Karen Wolfson, will be joining us in just a few moments to share what I know will be another uplifting and transformative message. Today's talk is titled, Who's in the Way? But first, the multi-talented Bob Teesdale is going to share a musical introduction to Reverend Karen's message, singing a Debbie Volterra song for us, which is also titled, Who's in the Way? We are grateful to welcome Bob Teesdale.
I say that I want to succeed, fulfill all my hopes and my needs. But no matter how much I plan and I scheme, seems there's somebody blocking my dreams. Who's in the way but me? I'm finally starting to see a person creating my reality. It's time that I face it, it's me. I blamed other people for years for all of my sadness and tears. Taking some time, but I'm finally free. Good fortune is coming to me. It's been a long, long road, but I can carry the load because I believe. Gonna make it now, find a way somehow. The truth is so plain to see. Who's in the way but me? I'm the only person I see. But things will be changing, I can guarantee. The truth is so plain to see. Who's in the way but me? I'm the only person I see. How things will be changing, I can guarantee. I've been playing this game. Sick of things just staying the same. The only one in my way
Hi, everyone. And thank you, Bob, for that powerful question, that beautiful song, Who's in the Way But Me? Interesting question, because in the face of what we've been dealing with in the last 3 months or so, this global crisis, this pandemic, it would seem that everything else is in the way. Certainly not me. In the way of what? In the way of living my life the way I'd like to, in the way of the fulfillment of my desires and the way of life as I knew it. But that's the power and the beauty of this teaching of New Thought Science of Mind. It gives us the ability, or it reminds us that we have the ability to experience whatever the conditions are in our lives, experiencing them in a way that gives us peace and joy, success and fulfillment. So, who's in the way but me? Maybe a difficult question to answer sometimes, but we'll explore that today. And the power behind that answer, who's in the way but me? And I'm going to illustrate it by using a parable. A parable, and it's titled The Parable of the Ice Maker. But before we get into all of that, let's check in. I want you to know that you're the reason I'm here. You're the reason that this feels so good, this connection. It's knowing that you're there. And I love getting your emails, so keep those coming. Keep letting me know how you're doing, what's going on in your life. And if you're watching on Facebook, as we always ask you, please let us know where you're watching from, and also maybe add a comment or two about how life is for you these days. And to you who are our financial contributors, thank you. You are an integral part of the team that makes it possible for us to do this, to share our love, our message, our caring, and to be connected in community in this way. So thank you. And thanks to all of you for being with us today. I want you to know that I think of you and see you each week during the week when you come into my mind as simply this: abundantly supported and vibrantly healthy in every way. So, 3 months we are now, 3 months into this crisis, this pandemic, and as I'm feeling, and I know you are at times, we can feel overwhelmed and helpless at the sheer magnitude of this. And as I said, there's no shortage of targets to blame. If only this hadn't happened, if only they would fix the situation, or if they would do what I think is the right thing, or if they would just get out of my way so that I could live my life, or if this pandemic could get out of the way so I could live my life. Yeah. Who's in the way? Well, the truth is, you and I don't have to wait for all of that to be at peace, to feel secure, to feel free, to feel successful. We don't have to wait until those people, those circumstances, those conditions, all of that, including the pandemic, till all of that is out of the way. We don't have to wait. Would you be terribly annoyed with me if I asked you to be willing to entertain the possibility that there's no one and nothing in the way but you? And of course, I have to take that for me too. There's no one and nothing in the way of my good experience of my life but me. Remember that when I point my finger at someone, three of my fingers are pointing back at me. I know. I don't particularly like to face that about myself. But I have discovered on more than one occasion in my life that, well, it happens to be what's going on. Now, the master teacher Jesus often spoke using teaching stories, or he called them parables. And so today, as I said, I'm going to do that with you. I'm going to share a parable with you, and it is a personal parable from my life. and it's called The Parable of the Ice Maker. The Parable of the Ice Maker. Here's what happened. 2.5 months ago, the automatic ice maker in my refrigerator just stopped working. Now, that's one of those conveniences that I count on. I depend on it. I don't even think about it. I take it for granted, I guess. And suddenly it stopped. I searched the entire freezer trying to figure out what might be the reason for it stopping. All I could see was a red light sensor, and it seemed to be fine. Well, needless to say, I was frustrated. I was aggravated. It was not pretty. And with the COVID contagion looming, and it was just 2.5 months ago, so you know, things were very unknown then. I did not have confidence in inviting in a repair person to fix the problem. And besides that, I had found that although I don't have a fancy refrigerator, the parts for that refrigerator are exorbitantly expensive. And of course, I started to complain about the inconvenience of not having that ice maker. What was I going to do? Well, of course, I could go get a plastic old-fashioned ice tray, and I did that. But meanwhile, in my mind, the whole situation escalated. My imagination went into high gear, into the worst case scenarios. I don't know if you've ever done this. Maybe you have. Maybe I'm not the only one. But here's where it went. It was, what else is going to malfunction now and going to require an expensive part, most likely? What if my refrigerator stops cooling? If that happens, I'll have to put what food I can in my picnic ice chest, and probably a whole lot of it would go to waste, and that would be an expense. And what if my refrigerator quit working altogether and I had to get a new one? I could still clearly remember the hassle of getting a new refrigerator and having to transfer food from the old to the new. Well, the way my imagination was working reminded me of a story about George. George was waiting on the platform at a train station, and he noticed a man nearby, so he decided to ask him for the time, and the man ignored him. So George asked him again, and the man still ignored him. Well, George was getting very frustrated, so he asked the man, "I've asked you for the time twice now. Why are you ignoring me?" So the man shrugged and he said, "Well, here's the thing. We're both waiting for the train. And if I answer you, well, when we get on the train, then you'll come and sit by me and we'll probably start talking. And then I'll probably invite you to my house for Sunday dinner. And there you're going to meet my daughter and you will probably like her. And eventually you'll want to marry her. And to be honest with you, why would I want a son-in-law who can't afford a watch?" Silly story, but isn't that the way our imagination can go? And all those stories were going on in whose mind? My mind. Nobody else's. All those scenarios were in my mind. Worst case scenario. So I see this as a parallel to what happened to us 3 months ago. Life was good, rather predictable. We were enjoying ourselves, getting together with family and friends, shopping, eating in restaurants, gathering in groups. And we no doubt took things for granted. And suddenly everything stopped. So many things we counted on and took for granted just stopped. They were gone. So let me ask you, as this happened, did your imagination kick into high gear, creating worst case scenarios? And did those stories contribute to your peace of mind, your productivity, your creativity, your sense of well-being? Of course not. So you see where I'm going with this? Who's in the way? Who's in the way? So to continue with the parable of the ice machine. Ice maker, ice machine, ice maker. You know what I'm talking about. I complained to friends. I had several who suggested, well, Have you checked to see if there's some ice blocking the some mechanism so it can't make the ice? And I said, well, yes, there is some ice in the bin, but there's no way that I can see that it's blocking anything in any way. It simply depends on that red sensor having a clear path to, you know, to trigger the ice making process. So I was very, very sure that the ice in the bin was not the problem, and that this was just, anyway, I wasn't gonna dump out that ice. I wanted that ice, what little I had, you know, I was gonna kind of hang on to it just in case. Did you ever do that? Cling to something despite wise advice to the contrary? And then find out later that that was the very thing that was in the way of the solution you were so desperately seeking. We do that, don't we? We get in our own way. We cling to shoulds. Things should be a certain way. People should behave a certain way. The need to be in control of everything. We cling to our stories. We cling to our opinions. Well, I was clinging to that ice, and I was stubbornly clinging to my belief that the ice in the bin was not the problem. That was not the problem. End of story. Who was in my way? Well, one day, I don't know, about a week ago, I decided to make some hard-boiled eggs. And the way that I do it is put them in a saucepan with water and bring it to a boil, and then take it off the heat, let it sit for about 20 to 30 minutes, and then plunge the eggs into ice-cold water. So in order to get the cold water ready for my eggs that were boiling, I decided I would have to go ahead and, yes, use that little ice that I had, but use that was in the bin. I really didn't want to. I'd been hanging on to it, but I decided I had to if my eggs were going to be done right. So very reluctantly, I dumped that ice into the bowl, made my ice water, and my eggs cooled. Well, that's not the end of the story. I bet you know where I'm going now. About 2 hours later, I was startled because I heard this noise in the kitchen. And I realized it was my ice maker making ice. Familiar sound. Well, I was overjoyed. I was amazed. And turns out I was quite embarrassed too, to realize that I had been in the way the whole time. Remember my worst case scenario stories too? Well, they evaporated the moment my ice maker started working. Just all that worry, all that fretting, and I wouldn't have needed to bother with that because it was working. The solution, the ice maker sensor had been patiently waiting to do what it does, but had been waiting for me to get that ice out of the way. Get out of the way. I could have had an ice maker working for 6 weeks, except for, well, I think you get my point. And the way this turned out reminded me of something about when we pray. And yes, I prayed. I mean, I'll pray for anything and everything. Why not? We know God is infinite. That which answers our prayers is infinite. I mean, why not? So, of course, I had prayed. But here's the thing. It reminded me that solutions or answers to prayer often come in ways we might never, ever imagine. But we can be in our own way because we think we know exactly what that answer, that solution is going to look like and how it's going to come about. Instead of getting out of our own way, letting go of that, doing the prayer, doing the affirmation, but then leaving the rest of it to the intelligence of the universe, the infinite, you know, it will draw resources from the ends of the earth to bring about the perfect, perfect solution in the perfect timing, in the perfect right way. Thomas Troward, who was an early New Thought teacher, said it this way. He said, If we will refrain from thinking of our desired solution as contingent on any appearance or conditions whatsoever, we can await the result with cheerful expectancy. Contingent on nothing. So, to wrap this up, here are the three lessons in the parable of the ice maker, which is a reminder that you and I are in charge of our life experiences. Either we're in the way or we get out of the way. And no matter what's going on, we can impact the quality of the experience. So, number one lesson, ask yourself, are my imagined worst case scenarios helping my peace of mind, or are they in the way? Seems fairly obvious, doesn't it? Lesson number two, ask yourself, what am I clinging to? And could that be in the way of the very thing that I'm seeking? And lesson number three, ask yourself, am I in my own way because I'm stuck in my idea of what it should look like, the answer to my prayer, the solution to my problem? Am I in my own way because I think I know what it's supposed to look like and how it's supposed to happen? And I know it can be very unnerving to let go of blaming circumstances or people. And it can be very unnerving to therefore get out of our own way. But when you realize that you're not alone, that makes all the difference. You heard that beautiful chant, God is holding me. God is holding me. You're not alone. Ernest Holmes, the architect of our philosophy, expressed it so beautifully. Listen to this. The friend that is within you anticipates your every desire, knows your every need. Since it is a personification of God, it is infinite, is not limited by your previous experiences, your present conditions, or passing situations. You may trust this friend for all your tomorrows, assuring that you are forever protected and safe. God is not, nor can ever be, separated from us, but too often we separate ourselves from God. Who's in the way but me? Bob has written a beautiful song that affirms all of this for us. The title is, I'm going to do my best. And then it goes on to say, and let God do the rest. Enjoy, and I'll see you next time.
I'm gonna do my best and let God do the rest. Let my faith keep me going when life puts me to the test. And I'll prove it every day, where there's God, there's a way. When I do my best, I know God can do rest. Well, I'm gonna do my best and let God do the rest. Let my faith keep me going when life puts me to the test. And I'll prove it every day, where there's God, there's a way. When I do my best, I know God will do the rest. Sometimes it's one step forward, then it's two steps back. When frustration overcomes me, I gotta cut myself some slack. If I've got to move a mountain, I don't have to do it all. Cause God's always there to lend a hand anytime I call. So I'm gonna do my best and let let God do the rest. Let my faith keep me going when life push me to the test. And I'll prove it every day. When there's God, there's a way. When I do my best, I know God will do the rest. Now there's a long, long road, and I got so far to go. And it seems I'll never get there when I'm walking on my own. When there's a big pile of trouble weighing on my mind, I can count on the Spirit to help me every time. So I'm gonna do my best and let God do the rest. Let my faith keep me going when life puts me to the test. But I'll prove it every day. Where there's God, there's a way. When I do my best, I know God will do the rest. I'm gonna do my best and let God do the rest. Let my faith keep me going when life puts me to the test. When I prove it every day, well, it's God, there's a way. When I do my best, I know God will do the rest. Gonna do my best and let God do the rest. Let my faith keep me going when life puts me to the test.
Powerful message, and for guiding us in how we can allow more of our good. Many thanks to Bob as well for sharing his many gifts with us today, perfectly anchoring all that Reverend Karen shared with us through his music. We want you to know that the Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota is here to support you in knowing the power and presence of your spiritual essence. We are here to offer prayer support, inspiration, encouragement, and opportunities for virtual community and connection. We appreciate your financial gifts so that we can continue to offer support to you. There are three simple ways to share your gift. On your screen, you'll see our website where you can select the donate button. This allows you to contribute via PayPal or credit card. You can mail a check to our address or set up automatic contributions through your own online banking. And now I invite you to take your virtual gift in your hand, place it over your heart, blessing it as you affirm with me. I give thanks that I may share of my good, my love, and my support. My gift goes forth to heal, to bless, and to prosper, and the divine flow returns it to me, multiplied abundantly. If you have a prayer request, you can send it to us by selecting the green prayer request button on our website. Our three licensed spiritual practitioners, Kathleen Frankert, Jim Grove, and me, stand by, ready to know and affirm spiritual truth with and for you. Here on our website, you can sign up for our weekly email newsletter or click on our Facebook link to see posts about upcoming events. As a reminder, every Wednesday night from 7 to 8 p.m., our spiritual living circles continue via Zoom conferencing. These free, informal, inspirational time and community is open to all, and discussion focuses on an article from the current Science of Mind magazine. If you would like to participate and receive your midweek realignment, email the facilitator, licensed spiritual practitioner, Jim Grove. Now, as we conclude this sacred time together, let us move forward into our day and this week, knowing that we go forward in health, in safety and in peace. I now invite you to join in singing this beautiful song of affirmation, Let There Be Peace on Earth. Have a wonderful week, everyone.
On earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God our Creator, we are family. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow, to take each moment and live each moment in peace eternal.